Good morning, students. Today we are going to start the very first topic of class 8. The very first topic is chapter number 1, rational number. Students, maintain your notes. Mention date, day, and the name of the chapter. Before starting the topic of rational numbers, let us recapitulate the different types of number which we have discussed in the previous classes. That is natural numbers, natural numbers are also called counting numbers. It starts from 1, 2, 3 up to so on, all are natural numbers. And the next one is whole numbers. Whole numbers are all the natural numbers including 0 up to so on. Next is integers. Integers are all the positive, negative, and 0. Suppose minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, up to so on, all are the integers. Now, rational numbers are also considered as fractions, as you already have done. Rational numbers, which can be expressed as p by q form, where p and q are integers and q is not equal to 0. For example, 1 by 2 minus 3 by 5, 0. Now, how 0 is a rational number? We can write 0 as 0 upon 1, 0 upon 2, 0 upon 3. So, in this way, 0 is a rational number, but we cannot write 0 in the denominator of any number. That is 3 upon 0, we cannot write, it is not defined. Now the next is about the properties. The very first one property is closure property. Closure property for rational number is that for any two rational numbers A and B, A plus B is also a rational number. Let us take an example for the natural numbers first. Suppose I am having a natural number 2 plus 5 is equal to 7. Now as 2 is a natural number, 5 is also a natural number, then the sum of these two numbers is also a natural number. So we can say that natural numbers are closed under addition. In the similar manner, I have taken the examples for the rational number. The very first one is 3 by 5, 4 by 5. And the sum of these two numbers is again a rational number. So we can say that rational numbers are closed under addition. Now we will check it for the subtraction. Similarly, we will take the examples and we will prove that subtraction is also closed under closed for rational numbers. That is, I have taken two rational numbers, 7 by 8 and 3 by 8. The difference of these two numbers is again a rational number. So, rational numbers are closed for subtraction. Similarly, for the multiplication, we will take the examples 1 by 2 and 3 by 8. The product of the two numbers is again a rational number. So, rational numbers are closed for multiplication. Now let us see for division. Rational numbers are not closed under division. For any rational number A, A divided by 0 is not defined. As already we have discussed, the denominator of any rational number cannot be 0. So rational numbers are not closed under division. Now the next property is commutative property. Commutative property for any two rational numbers A and B, A plus B is equal to B plus A. That is, we can do the addition in any order. Let us take the example. I have taken two rational numbers 3 by 7 and 2 by 7. The sum of the two numbers is 5 by 7. When I have changed the order, firstly I have taken A plus B, then I have taken B plus A. The answer remains same. So, addition of rational number can be in any order. Now, what about subtraction? A minus B is not equal to B minus A. Let us take two numbers, 2 by 3 and 5 by 4. Firstly, I will take the difference of 2 by 3 and 5 by 4. Then I'll change the order 5 by 4 minus 2 by 3. Now you can see from the simplifications, the first one when I have taken a minus b, it is minus 7 by 12. And in the second term, b minus a, it is plus 7 by 12. So the two terms are not same. So that is why subtraction is not commutative for rational numbers. Now similarly, as addition is commutative, multiplication is also commutative. A multiplied by b is equal to b multiplied by a. That is, I have taken minus 7 by 3 multiplied by 6 by 5. You can also take the examples of your choice. Now the product of these two numbers is minus 42 by 15. By changing the order, it is again minus 42 by 15, as the both answers are same. So multiplication is commutative for rational numbers. Division. A divided by B is not equal to B divided by A. Now again take the example minus 5 by 4 divided by 3 by 7. The answer is minus 35 by 12. Now if I have changed the order B divided by A, then it is minus 12 by 35. So from the above example, you can see that division is not commutative for rational number, or we can say that rational numbers hold commutative property for addition and multiplication, but not for subtraction and division. So students, these are the two properties, introduction part. We will discuss next properties in the next video. Good morning students. Last day we have discussed the two properties, that is closure property and commutative property. Now next is associative property. Associated property is little bit same like commutative property, but in this property we will take three rational numbers A, B and C. The order of addition is, firstly we will take B plus C, then the answer will be added to A, and in the second step if we will add A plus B then to C, the both answers remains same. It means that addition can be done in any order. Now take the example, I have taken three rational numbers minus 2 by 3, 3 by 5, minus 5 by 6. Firstly I will add B to C, then the answer to A, that is 3 by 5 plus minus 5 by 6, then the answer is added to 2 by 3 and the final answer is minus 9 by 10. When I have changed the order, that is firstly I have added A plus B, that is minus 2 by 3 is added to 3 by 5, then it is added to minus 5 by 6 and the answer remains same. So we can say that addition is associated for rational numbers. Now what about subtraction? Similarly, commutative property, subtraction is not associative for the rational numbers. You can prove it by taking the examples. Multiplication is associative for the rational numbers. Again, you can take the examples of your choice and prove the same. Similarly, as we have done in the commutative property, division is not associative for rational numbers. Now, the next one is additive inverse. Additive inverse is actually the negative of a number. For any rational number A, additive inverse is minus A and vice versa. For example, a rational number 2 by 3. If I want to take the additive inverse of 2 by 3, then the answer is minus 2 by 3. If I will take the example of negative number, suppose it is minus 5 by 7, then the additive inverse will be plus 5 by 7. So you can say that the negative of a number or additive inverse is same. In general, for any integer a, a plus minus a is equal to 0, and for rational number a upon b, a plus b plus negative of a upon b is equal to 0, which is called additive identity. 0 is also called additive identity for rational number or any integers, natural number, all that. Now the multiplicative inverse. multiplicative inverse is same as reciprocal of a number. If we want to take the reciprocal of any number or multiplicative inverse, it is same. For any rational number a upon b, multiplicative inverse is b upon a. Or you can say that a upon b multiplied by b upon a is equal to 1. This is called multiplicative identity. 1 is also called multiplicative identity. If I want to take the multiplicative inverse of minus 2 by 3, then minus 2 by 3, multiplicative inverse will be 3 by 2 minus 3 by 2. The last property of this topic is distributive property of multiplication over addition and subtraction. For any three rational numbers a, b and c, a into b plus c is equal to AB plus AC. This is called distributive property. The question can be in any form. It may be in the form of AB plus AC. Then you can convert in this way, A into B plus C. Or the question can be in the form of A into B plus C. Then you can use this type. This is similar for the subtraction. A into B minus C is equal to AB minus AC. So students, this is all for the exercise 1.1 introduction part. We will discuss exercise 1.1 in the next part. So students, carefully revise all the properties so that we can start the exercise. Good morning students. Today we are going to start exercise 1.1 of chapter number 1, rational numbers. Question number 1 is, using appropriate properties, find the value of 2 by 5 multiplied by minus 3 by 7, minus 1 by 6 multiplied by 3 by 2 plus 1 by 14 multiplied by 2 by 5. As this question we are to do by the properties, so firstly let us see which properties we will use. In this question, we will use two properties. The first one is commutative property. That is, A plus B is equal to B plus A. Now, how this property will be used? As we know, A plus B can be written as B plus A. So, in this question, let us see. This is first term, this is second term, and this is third term. Now see the first and the third term. These two terms have 2 by 5. So firstly we will arrange the second and third term. That is, the second term will be replaced by third term by use of commutative property. That is, 2 by 5 multiplied by minus 3 by 7 plus 1 by 14 multiplied by 2 by 5 minus 1 by 6 multiplied by 3 by 2. Write down the property as well. That is commutative property. Now also we have discussed distributive property. In distributive property, we are having A into B plus C. It can be written as AB plus AC. Now, AB plus AC is given to us. We will take common A. Here, 2 by 5 is common in these two terms. So, it can be written as 2 by 5. Now, here is minus 3 by 7. Plus 1 by 14. This term remains same. Now do the simplifications and also write down the properties which you are using. The LCM of 7 and 14 is 14. 7 2's the 14, so 3 2's the 6, it's minus 6 plus 1. 3 2 is the 6, so it is minus 1 by 4. 2 by 5, minus 6 plus 1 is minus 5. 14, minus 1 by 4. Do the simplifications. 5 and 5 cancel. 2 1's the 2. 7 2 is the 14. So it is minus 1 by 7, minus 1 by 4. Now again take the LCM. LCM of 7 and 4 is 28. So it's minus 4 and minus 7. Minus 4, minus 7. Both will be added is minus 11 by 28 is the answer. Now question number 2. In question number 2, we will write down the additive inverse. As we have done in the last lecture, additive inverse is actually the negative of a number. So if I want to write down the negative of this positive number or additive inverse of 2 by 8, it is minus 2 by 8. And second part is negative number. So the additive inverse of a negative number is a positive number. So additive inverse of minus 5 by 9 is plus 5 by 9. Now for the third part, it is minus 6 upon minus 5. Both numerator and denominator have the negative signs, so they will cancel each other. In actually, this number is a positive number. So the additive inverse of minus 6 upon minus 5 is minus 6 by 5.